I'm switching to Adobe Rush. What up, guys? Welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear, and well, technically I did switch to Adobe Rush in the last episode, so this video is kind of like a normal format video. In this video, I will give you my thoughts about Adobe Rush, and in order to do so, I will take you along as I edited my last video, so you will know how my whole workflow worked with the iPad and the iPhone and also the MacBook. So normally I'm using Final Cut Pro in order to get all my video edits done. In this video, I also wanted to give you my first impressions with Adobe Rush and also kind of like a basics tutorial on what you can expect from Adobe Rush as a first-time user. The video I took while I was editing my last video was right from the start, so that was the first time I ever opened up Adobe Rush. I had no prior experience with Adobe Rush, and this was really the first time I ever used it. And for me personally, the most shocking thing was that I was able to create a full-on YouTube video with B-roll, with music, with overlays, and everything else I do. Almost everything else I do in my normal videos within 1.5 hours just on my iPad. But before we get into any more details about Adobe Rush, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and make sure to hit the bell in order to get notified whenever I post new content like this today. And also check out my written articles under eddie-bear.com. First, I want to talk about the workflow, how I actually edited and recorded the whole video. So my recording device was my iPhone XS, and I edited the whole footage on my iPad Pro. So this is actually one of the absolute unique features of Adobe Rush. You can edit with this little tool on every available platform, no matter whether it's a Windows machine, a Mac, or an iPhone, iPad, or an Android device, you name it. You can use every single device you have at your disposal. And another cool thing is that every project you are doing is synced across all the other devices. Naturally, you can select whether a project should be synced on a device or whether it shouldn't, but it gives you way more flexibility when it comes to the editing. You can start your edit while you're on the go, on a plane or whatnot. And when you arrive at home, you can continue your edit without any disruption in your complete workflow. As with pretty much every video editing tool out there, you start by naming your project and importing all the content you were recording, whether it's local content or content that is stored somewhere in the cloud. So in order for you to being able to edit your video in a fast way, Adobe Rush is actually optimizing your footage, or at least parts of it, when you are importing it into the library, so you can edit your video without any frame drops. So whenever you are handling 4K files, even the iPad or the PC is so optimized that you can skim through your clips without any kind of stuttering or lags that you may experience on your MacBook or on your laptop. The first time I fired up Adobe Rush, I was really surprised how streamlined and how user-friendly actually their whole UI is. So you are not bombarded with a huge amount of buttons and sliders and whatnot. So you have a really clean design that makes it easy for a beginner or somebody who is not used to use Adobe products to get familiar with Adobe Rush. And the cool thing is that the UI of Adobe Rush works the same on an iPad as it works on an iPhone and also on your MacBook. So it is optimized for touch interaction, but it also works great when you are sitting in front of a laptop. After you imported all your clips into your timeline, you easily can maneuver through it by just swiping left or right. And if you want a more detailed view of a certain clip, you just have to pinch and you get a deeper zoomed in view onto a certain clip. While I was using Rush, I quickly stumbled upon a feature called Expand Audio. So this basically does nothing else than expand the view of your audio. So this will help you to get the right spot where you want to cut your clip. Since we are already talking about cutting, you have two options how you can cut your clips into length. So you either drag the end or the beginning of a clip and park it where you want it to begin or end, or you hit the scissors symbol on the left, and in order to get rid of any unwanted footage, you just have to hit the trash bin on the left and it will remove the clip from your timeline. As I mentioned in the beginning, I kinda cheated a bit while I was editing the video, so I not only edited it on my iPad, I used my MacBook in order to include my intro into the whole edit. So I just launched my Rush on the MacBook. I inserted the video clip, then I waited till it got synced up to the cloud, and then I reopened my project on the iPad, and there you had it. My intro was included into the whole project without the need for me to transfer my intro onto my iPad. So this makes it really simple. If you have some footage on different kind of devices, you just have to fire up Rush, drop your footage into it, and it will do the rest for you. Dropping audio or music into your Adobe Rush timeline works the same as it does with video files. So you import the file into your library, then you browse it in your library and you drop it onto your timeline, and boom, there you have it. You have music in your video. One feature I was really pumped about is the auto duck feature of Adobe Premiere, which also got included into Adobe Rush. And this feature is something I've been really missing in Final Cut. So what it basically does is it will automatically level the audio of your music. So meaning you're playing your audio and the moment you stop talking, Rush recognizes the stop in your audio level and it will increase the audio level from your music. So if you're doing a tutorial kind of video content or stuff where you not continuously are talking, Rush will take care for you with the whole audio leveling of your music, and you don't have to set in keyframes and, you know, adjust the level of the music, drop it, raise it, and it can get tedious and takes a lot of time. And this is pretty much you hit the checkbox and you define how high your audio level should be, and you're good to go. You don't have to do any kind of other adjustments. So this is a big time saver. Adobe Rush also naturally covers a lot of other features like color correcting. You can do transitionings, you can add in text, use different kind of filters. Naturally, it's also able to handle multiple video streams on top of each other, so you can easily incorporate, for example, B-roll. So what's my overall opinion about Adobe Rush? In my personal opinion, Adobe was able to create a very versatile product that will also cover beginners and not so experienced users, and is actually offering a lot of features that even prosumers or professionals will enjoy to use while they are traveling. And this is made possible because Adobe Rush is available on every available platform. Naturally, this also comes with some risks. So since this is a cloud-based product, this means you will have to have a huge cloud storage. And at the moment, Adobe is only naturally supporting their own cloud, so Adobe Creative Cloud. And you can also have your footage stored on Dropbox. There is no integration into Google Drive and no native integration into iCloud. So this means if you're an iPhone or Apple user, you will have to have your footage locally synced on your device in order to be able to import it into Adobe Rush. And since all your footage is in the cloud, there's also the risk that you have to sync throughout all the platforms. So this means if you're sitting somewhere in a remote location in a hotel, you will have to have a good data connection if you have remote footage that you need to access. But I think the negative sides from the cloud are actually well compensated by the premium features you get through Adobe Rush, for example, with the auto dock for audio. And also you have the easy usability of the whole user interface and all the features that are easy accessible, and you don't need like a 200-hour training in order to master Adobe Rush. So what do you think about Adobe's newest kit on the block? Is it something you have considered for yourself, or are you kinda hesitating to jump on the new horse? By the way, would you be interested in me doing more tutorials for Adobe Rush? Hit me up in the comments and let me know what you think. So with that said, thanks again for watching, and I see you in the next one.